We receive evidence from all across the southwest part of the United States, including California, Arizona, Nevada, Hawaii, and the Pacific Islands.
Inside this drug lab in Vista, California, an hour north of the border, you get a sense of our state's drug problem, of the country's drug problem. We're not talking about opioids, cocaine, or heroin. We're talking about meth.
So this was received from Arizona from a port of entry, and it's 174 packages that we see here. And each one of these packages is about a pound in weight.
The amount of methamphetamine on this table is scary. But this is just one shipment and one seizure.
In the past few years, we have seen an incredible uptick in the amount of drugs flowing into our country.
Nathan Jones is the assistant special agent in charge of the San Diego DEA. Meth is the current drug of choice, and it seems a lot of Americans have chosen it. In San Diego alone, the DEA seized more than 45,000 pounds of meth last year. That's more than double what they seized just 3 years ago.
Is it coming through the ports of entry that's being smuggled through that way, or is it coming through areas where there are insecurities within the border fencing?
It's both, okay? You have to look at these organizations, these cartels in Mexico, they're a business model. They have a product and they want to get it to the market, which unfortunately America is the biggest market for drugs in the world.
And this is some of the strongest meth the DEA has ever seen.
Before, 5-10 years ago, it would look like I took that and just rolled it around in the mud a little bit and put it in the dirt. It's a little darker brown, has more impurities in it. Sometimes it was cut more. So the coloration and the purity is significantly better.
And this meth, seized and brought to the DEA lab, is just what they catch. Thousands more pounds get across the border and into California. And from there, it makes its way to all parts of the U.S. And this meth isn't cooked in someone's kitchen or backyard shed.
You have these massive super labs right now in Mexico that are producing tens of thousands of pounds, tens of thousands of liters.
And the effects of this booming drug trade are adding more fuel to America's crisis on the border. With border agents spending more of their time caring for refugees, there are fewer of them on the front lines, making it that much easier for the cartels to get drugs across.
They know that if you're tied up with enough families or enough people to process, then that means all of a sudden there's some openings and some opportunities for them.
Yes, and now we're talking about maybe groups of 50, to 100 turning themselves in at one point, at one time. So the amount of agents required to be able to transport all these people to the stations, the amount of agents that's required to be able to take these people to the hospital, to process all these large amount of people, it just takes all of our manpower.
So the smugglers sit, watch for the refugees and the arrests, and then make their move. Which brings us back to the migrant embassy in Tijuana and Hugo Castro, who draws a connection between the drugs and the asylum seekers.
The war against drugs has created more violence in Mexico and Central America, and there's no solution.
He believes the United States' demand for drugs is the root cause of the violence and corruption in Latin America that causes so many to flee north. So in essence, what he's saying is, if not for America's appetite for drugs, life on the other side of the border would be better for people like Alba, her daughter, and thousands of others. And maybe, just maybe, we wouldn't have the refugee crisis we have now.